Welcome to the next video about mocap cleanups in Cascadeur. Previously, we've created a rig for our character. However, we didn't get into details about the controllers and how to use them for posing. While posing is more important in creating animation from scratch than in mocap cleanups, it's still a vital tool. And at this point, we needed to move forward. So now, let me tell you more about the controller system and how to set up the poses. In this video, you will find out why we have different controller types, how the different controllers are related, how to set up poses using AutoPosing and regular controllers, how to adjust the manipulators, how to mirror and copy poses. As an example, let's use a pre-made character today. For instance, this one that we've created the rig for in the previous step. Or you can use one of the pre-made sample characters from the starter menu. So, we have three types of controllers: AutoPosing, point controllers, and box controllers. You can also customize the display of controllers in any mode by right-clicking on the View Mode button. For example, I can see all the controllers simultaneously. All the controllers are interconnected. No matter what type of controllers you choose to edit, it automatically changes the position of all other controllers. They all change together and you can easily switch between them. The only difference is that each set of controllers has its own features and limitations. AutoPosing uses AI for faster pose setting. Blue points are the active points and they form the request. By default, it's the feet points that are always active. When you click on the point, you can see the manipulator's axis. And here you can select the type of a manipulator, translate or rotate. You can also use the hotkeys here. Hold down the mouse button to move the selected controller. You can move the controllers along the axis or along the plane, which is more convenient for the feet. If you select the circle in the middle of the manipulator, the controller can be moved freely in the plane of the screen. So here, take a look at how the fit position forms the request for the pose. Now, the entire body is following the feet. Now let me select the directions controller. I want my character to be facing in this direction. As soon as I move the direction controller, it activates and becomes part of the request. And the color changes to blue. Now, it will be taken into account and will start influencing the pose. You can reverse this and deactivate the controller using this button. Or by using the hotkeys Shift plus Z. The pose might change immediately, since this controller is now following the active controlling point. In this example, it will only be the feet points. You can move and rotate different body parts. Be mindful of the fact that rotating certain body parts will automatically activate related points. For rotations, it's often convenient to select several objects at once. You can add points to the selection or remove the selection by holding down the Shift key. You can also select the points by outlining the area. In AutoPosing, only the active points will be selected if you're using the area highlight. If there are no active points, then all the points will be selected. Double-clicking on any point will select all the points down below in the hierarchy. You can change the pivoting point using the right mouse click. I recommend using the heel point. It's right here in gray, which means that it's not active in the request for the pose. But it is easy to use if you set it as a pivot point. You can find examples of various poses in shorts on our YouTube channel. They can be very helpful in understanding the general principles and concepts. As for the mocap cleanups, it's not that important to be able to set up a pose from scratch. But you do need to understand the principle of posing using active points. Inactive points will be positioned in a way that seems the most natural to the AI. This effect comes in very handy when cleaning up a mocap when you need to correct the natural position of any body parts in different poses. For example, I have the scene with unnaturally raised toes. First of all, I can select all the auto-posing controllers and activate them. This way, they will all remain in their places and form a pose request. And now I can deactivate these points, and thus they will adjust themselves. I will talk about this in more detail later. For now, let's make sure we understand all the different types of controllers. In auto posing, you can activate the modes to edit fingers. The idea is the same here. The index finger and the little finger greatly influence the positions of the other fingers. Fingers controllers can also be activated or deactivated. And finally, you can additionally turn on rotation controllers to get the full control. Moving on to the next type, point controllers. This is our usual rig without the AI assistance. In this mode, only the selected points are moving. Points can still affect each other, but not in the same way as in auto-posing. For example, if I drag the character by the hand here, all other points will still follow. This happens because the point controllers are attached to the physical rig of the character. By the way, the physical settings only work with those parts of the character for which point controllers were created. For those rigs where auto-posing cannot be used, points are the main controllers in Cascadeur. In all fairness, auto-posing also works kind of on top of the points. In essence, auto-posing is an intelligent system for simplifying the process of setting points. If you set the points first and then switch to the auto-posing mode, then the auto-posing system will automatically prompt you to record all controllers for which the corresponding points have been changed. Working with controller points is slightly different than working with auto-posing. It's better to move points in groups. Moving just one point at a time is not only inconvenient, but also may look funny. However, in some cases, with proper practice, it can also be a viable option. In general, when dealing with points, it's a lot easier to using this rotate function instead of just moving them. Please make sure you always select all the needed points, since rotating a single one doesn't make any sense. Please pay attention to the manipulation mode. It can be global, in which case the axis of the manipulator mode corresponds to the scene axis. Or it can be local, in which case the axis of the manipulator corresponds to the axis of the selected object. For example, bending the arms at the elbows is better in local mode. This way, you're not going to involve the shoulders. By the way, you can fix points using the hotkeys R as in Romeo. Fixed points do not move when other points move. They also lock all points further down the chain. And of course, if you select the point yourself, you can move it around. And it won't block the movement of the point during the animation. To remove the fixed point position, you need to press R on your keyboard again. And finally, the third type of the controllers, box controllers. The operating principles of the box controllers are very similar to the point controllers. However, they look slightly different. A particular feature of the box controllers is that they don't need to be attached to a physical rig. In other words, some of the box controllers completely replicate the other controllers, but some rig elements will only have the box controllers. For example, some facial elements, small elements of clothing, and twists. We definitely don't need to attach controllers to the physics when it comes to characters' eyes or mouth. Since they don't participate in any collisions, they are irrelevant when we're trying to figure out the center of mass, etc. So for these elements, you will only have box controllers, There are no point controllers, no collision capsules, and nothing else. So here you have the main controller types and the way to use them. I recommend you practice them on different poses to get a hang of it. And now let me show you a couple more things that you might find useful. For example, you can mirror poses or parts of poses. To do so, you will need this menu. Here, you have to pay attention to the type of controllers. For instance, remember that there are no finger controllers in point controllers. So you can mirror the arm, but not the fingers. Therefore, I recommend using box controllers for mirroring. This way, you will definitely get all the elements. Another tool that you might need is copying the positions of body parts. Let's imagine I have a couple of keys with different poses. And now I want to copy the legs position so that they stand in the same place in both frames. By the way, I will also teach you how to work with keys later. For now, I'm selecting the leg controllers in one of the keys. Next, I press Ctrl plus C. Then I go to the next key and press Ctrl plus V. You can see that the positions have been copy-pasted, and by the way, they've been copied in the global mode. That's why they don't move at all. Here, be mindful of the character's position. If it is too different in the second key, then an attempt to copy the controllers in the global mode will affect the body parts in a way that they're kind of dragging the others with them. So to protect the important part of the pose, I recommend you fix some of the points. And you can also copy in the local mode. For example, when I need the character to hold the hand in the exact same way as in this frame, but at the same time I want the body to be moved this way. And here what's going to happen if I copy the arm in the global mode. In this situation, I need to copy the arm in the local mode. And of course, don't forget to watch the fingers. And actually, this is the easiest way to copy the finger positions. And there is another useful tool that you can find here called relative to pivot mode. Let's say I want to copy the arm position relative to this cube, but my cube moved in a different key. Here, I'll choose the cube as my pivot point. This is exactly the type of situation when you would want to use this tool. In real life, it's not going to be the cube, it's going to be different weapons, transport, and other things. Or you might need to copy the arm relative to other body parts. In all these different examples, you will be using the same principle. And now I'll briefly touch upon the manipulator settings. You can access the settings by going into Scene Settings, Manipulators. Let's take a closer look. Arrows step. Along with your mouse, you can also move the manipulators by using the arrows on your keyboard. This setting helps you select how far you want the manipulators to move with every keyboard press. When this option is enabled, moving manipulators with a mouse is going to happen in selected increments, and you will see this mark next to the manipulator. There is a similar option for rotations, for instance, if I want the rotation to happen only in 90 degrees increments. Next, you have sensitivity settings. A quick life hack here, if you hold down Ctrl button, then the speed of the manipulator adjusting is going to decrease drastically, which allows you for more detailed adjustments. And if you hold down Ctrl and right mouse button, you can change the size of the manipulator. Additionally, you can select certain manipulators and press S to get to the viewing mode, but you will still be able to control the selected object, and you won't be able to see other controllers that can distract you. And these were some of the tools that you might want to use in your animation journey. In the future videos, we will talk more about concrete examples and real-life animations. But this is it for this video. Don't forget to like it and also let us know what topics interest you the most. I'll see you very soon in the next video.